Here's the thing, and we'll talk about this fucking idiot, and we'll move on. So I was going to tell this story as if I actually, you know, because I was going to transition, tell the story first, so people are like, "What is talking about movies?" We're going to talk about movies. Don't worry, but this is like everything we talk about here. This is the show, and because this is about human behavior in general, right? So I did catch some of The Bachelorette this season with my wife, because the girl looked just like Clark Wolf.
She is Clark Wolf.
Just like
what's
Becca?
What's her name?
Yeah. Becca. She looked
Becca Koof.
Becca looks just like Clark Wolf. Mm-hmm. And as I was watching,
I texted you the
you
first
did when
episode.
She was on the other one.
Wait, can you pull her up?
Yeah, bring up Becca the Bachelor. So I watched a little bit of it, and then there was this guy with this long hair. This guy Leo, right? And he's got like this 1980s Fabio hairdo.
Oh, very Fabio-esque.
Yeah, he's got this hairdo, and look at her. Like, it looks like Clark Wolf.
There she is.
Yeah.
She's a
totally.
She looks like Clark Wolf.
And this one looks more like Clark Wolf. Go to this one.
Yeah.
Sorry,
I can't see. Yeah, right underneath the visual story one. Go underneath it. Right there. That one. Yeah, there you go. One over.
Yep. No. The one in the middle. Okay. Okay. No. There it is.
There you go.
That's Clark Wolf.
So this guy, he's like honest and open. I was like, okay, you can see where this guy is. He's got like this, he's trying to be like Jason Momoa, right? I'm like, all right, you know, I didn't see anything there. And so I'm watching this Bachelor in Paradise, and then the real dude comes out.
Leo.
His name's Leo, and he comes out, and I turn to my wife, and this is before he just gets there, right? I go, this guy's a scumbag. And she goes, what do you mean? How do you know that? And I go, I went to college with dudes like this. Mm-hmm. I go,
pull him up.
I go, this dude is just looking to fuck all these girls, is all he's trying to do.
How could
if you
tell?
Google Leo Bachelorette or Bachelor in Paradise, will come up.
I just had a feeling about him, right? I go, he's a liar. But
why did you think he was cool the first time?
Because the way they portrayed him, the way, again, from being a Bachelor, the way that they edited him, yeah, look at this fucking guy. And so, look at him. Jesus. But listen, what I'll tell you then, he's on the show, and he goes out with this girl, and he works, because there's this dude, Joe, where it seems like a guy that we'd hang out with.
Grocery Store Joe. Dude, Grocery Store Joe is the man.
He just seems like a guy you'd want to hang out with, similar to him, hey, right? Yeah. And so he's just a good dude. And this girl, I'll tell you, what's this girl's name that he's dating?
Kendall.
I got issues. I got issues with Kendall. I got issues. But
I don't blame you. I got some issues with
Kendall
going on Paradise.
Wait, Kendall's dating Leo or Grocery Store Joe?
Both. And that's
both.
The whole point.
That's Paradise. That's why it's so interesting.
She was. So the problem was, though, so then, you know, and this guy's full of shit, right? So he's full of shit. And then he goes and he gets back from this long date. It's amazing.
What is this look? Cobster, I got your Halloween costume, buddy.
This is what this guy goes and shops for bagel bites with. This is what he fucking wears.
Come on now. He looks so down to earth. Look at that. You wouldn't want to grab a beer with that guy?
He probably swings a 32, too. Yeah.
Nobody shops for bagel bites. Bagel bites shop for you, Christian.
That's right. That's true. Well, he does, and that's why.
He's hot.
But that's why.
Oh, here we fucking go.
But here's the point. That's all the women said when he walked in. But then they all turned on him because he was such a scumbag. Then he's picking. He legit calls this woman full of shit in front of everybody, right? And then fucking throws a drink in Grocery Joe's face, right? Joe
There's
swears
a altercation.
But nobody throws a drink in another man. No man
That's
throws
what
a
I'm
drink
saying.
In another
yeah,
man.
But dude, I know. And, you know, he's a punk. And you can tell because he's like a 6'3" like stuntman, right?
Is Joe
but
big or no?
No, he's a normal, like normal dude.
Yeah, but he's from Chicago. He's a scrapper.
But he's like the nicest guy, and then he's just sticking up for his lady, and he puts his hands up. And I told my wife, I'm like, oh, look, he's putting his hands up. He's ready to scrap. My wife goes, you love this. And I'm like, because he's protecting this girl. But it's like, and then the next day, this girl, or no, it was the next day. It was right
Kendall.
Beforehand. Kendall
chooses
like
Leo.
No, she kisses some other guy.
She makes out with another guy.
What guy?
Venmo John.
Who reminds me of John. Dennis.
He does look like Dennis. Yeah.
He reminds me of Dennis.
Did he start Venmo or something?
He was one of the first ones in there.
That's why she kissed him.
Which is so insane. I'm not sure why he was on The Bachelor.
Here's the thing. I was doing a little bit of Google search when as soon as he said he did like technology for Venmo, he was part of like an early programming team, but he doesn't own anything in Venmo.
This is my overall problem with Bachelor and all the people that are on, a lot of people that are on this show. This guy's going to be accepted into the circles, and he'll probably be back on Bachelor in Paradise again. He'll probably wind up dating someone else from the show because he's this big.
I don't know.
Chad came and went, right?
Chad came and went, and nobody really. I mean, actually, Chad, I've met a couple times. Bad Chad. He's actually really nice.
Is that the milk guy?
Milk. He told Chris Harrison to go fuck himself. But this guy, this guy's like going after previous contestants on Twitter. Like he's like, remember Amanda Stanton?
Leo.
Yeah. Like he's like apparently because people are tweeting about him obviously and being like, this guy's a douchebag. And like he he like went after Tanner and was like, dude, I'll like if you want to fight, let me know. Like saying it on Twitter. Then apparently like Amanda Stanton tweeted was like, Leo just DM'd me said like stop talking shit about me on Twitter or it'll come back to haunt you. Right. Like he's like going after previous contestants.
You know who was a dickhead I watched? Juan Pablo.
He was a dickhead.
But jumping away from this turd.
Fuck you, Chris Harrison.
you can just tell he's a rotten human. And I just don't like people when they tweet out like stuff. He's like peace and love, and yet he's telling people he wants to fight them. He's throwing drinks. He's full of shit.
I hate that.
How many times do you read trolls on Twitter and then you go on their bio and it's like God, love, laugh. Yeah. Like, yeah. I just want peace on earth. And then they'll tweet at you and be like, you fucking suck.
And that's what this guy is. He's a troll.